baba.
Breaking news, Gumbura dies in prison. Robert Martin Gumbura was the pastor of the RMG Independent and Time Message Church in Zimbabwe. He was convicted of rape in 2014 and sentenced to prison. As of 2021, he remains in prison pending appeals and an application for bail. Conviction and sentencing. Gumbura was convicted of 4 counts of rape and 1 on possession of pornographic material. Testimony at the trial alleged that he had claimed he had the right to have sexual intercourse with any woman in his congregation. He was initially sentenced to 50 years in Chikurubi prison, but 10 years were suspended from his sentence for good behavior, resulting in an expected sentence of 40 years. His church was also suspended by Zimbabwe's religious body, the Apostolic Christian Council of Zimbabwe, ACCZ. On March 18, 2015, then Vice President and Justice Minister Emmerson Mnangagwa told the Parliament of Zimbabwe that Gumbura was one of more than 100 inmates involved in the planning of a violent riot over food that broke out at the prison on March 13. Jailed RMG Independent and Time Message leader Robert Martin Gumbura, who was imprisoned for 40 years last year for raping women from his church, will on Monday bounce back into the court, where the High Court is expected to hear his appeal. Gumbura was appealing against both conviction and the sentence imposed on him by the Harare Magistrates Courts last year. The man of the cloth, who was denied bail pending appeal, wanted the higher court to set aside the lower court's decision and acquit him of the charges. Gumbura faced 9 counts of raping 6 women and 1 of possessing pornographic material. He was cleared of 4 counts relating to 3 other women for lack of evidence. In his grounds of appeal, Gumbura accused the trial magistrate of negating his duties, arguing that he did not evaluate evidence of the witnesses to come up with an appropriate decision, insisting acquittal was the competent verdict under the circumstances. In this regard, the magistrate was regrettably swayed by non-legal considerations and passed a moral judgment, he said. Most fundamentally, the Honorable Court was obligated to critically examine each allegation of sexual intercourse in the surrounding circumstances. It was further enjoined to consider whether the delay in reporting the sexual offenses was not a factor indicative of the consensual nature of the sexual intercourse. Gumbura argues that there was need on the part of the magistrate to evaluate each piece of evidence and the position of the appellant, setting out why his evidence was not acceptable compared to that of the complainants. It is clear that the magistrate's finding that the complainants were credible is plainly wrong, he said. The honorable magistrate simply took lock, stock and barrel the narrative of the complainants, discarding the explanation given by the appellant and the probabilities. Gumbura was then being represented by advocate Thembi Nkosi Magwaliba, instructed by Ms. Rikai Maypasa of Maypasa, Ndamani and Maramba legal practitioner. In December 2013, Harare Regional Magistrate Hosea Mujaya heard Pastor Gumbura had given himself the authority to have sex with any female congregant of his choice in his church regardless of their marital status and could loan them out to their husbands, but still retain certain rights. It was also reported that Gumbura nearly had sex with every woman in church. His church reportedly had over 200 women, and is said to have had sex with over 100 women. Gumbura was not selective. He would play the hide-my-sausage game with you whether you are married or not. A leaked WhatsApp messages between 2 women who consented to having sex with Gumbura, despite one of them being a married man, revealed that of all the countless women Gumbura had sex with, he only used a condom on just 1 woman, who was said to be very beautiful but risky. The rest sampled his anaconda live and direct. What's more shocking in the leaked WhatsApp chat is that a married woman and that woman's daughter once took turns to have sex with Gumbura. In 2015, the then Vice President Emmerson Mnangagwa said Gumbura behind Chikurubi prison riots. The then Vice President and Justice Minister Emmerson Mnangagwa yesterday told Parliament that jailed RGM Independent and Time Message Church leader Robert Martin Gumbura, who is serving a 40-year jail term for rape, was among over 100 inmates who planned the violent food riots that broke out at Chikurubi Maximum Security Prison. The violence left 5 prisoners dead and several guards injured as over 900 inmates protested the poor diet served at the correctional facility. Mnangagwa made the remarks after then Zengeza West MP Simon Chidakwa, MDCT, demanded to know how government had responded to the riots. Said Mnangagwa, Chikurubi houses the most dangerous criminals in the country, robbers, rapists, infidels serving 45 years, 60 years, 70 years, and a group of them about 100 had conspired to break away from prison. Surprisingly also, Gumbura was chairing the conspiracy at the compound area where meals are served, and the mutiny was over the issue of there being no meat in their relish. Mnangagwa said the prisoners then broke some water pipes and kitchen furniture while others picked up bricks which they used to attack guards, resulting in 8 officers being injured. He added that, while the other inmates were rioting, the organizers were busy climbing prison walls trying to escape, and that resulted in the guards opening fire. It claimed that the organizers of the demonstrations had misled other prisoners that firearms carried by the guards were not loaded, hence they were harmless. One inmate was shot and he died. They began to retreat and some got wounded in the process, and in total 5 prisoners have died. We have enhanced security at Chikurubi Maximum Prison and have put the troublesome prisoners in the penal section. Repairs are also underway on the damaged roof. 2 prisoners had climbed the roof to escape and were shot at.
Baba.